Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch RC channel for a review of the content of this here box. An understated box, and it contains a phone. Yes, you've seen the title. And I got this one from Gearbest. It's the Xiaomi Mix 2, version 2. Now, originally I just ordered this phone for my own use. I hadn't planned on reviewing it. However, I came across quite a number of reviews of this phone, which looked of high quality. The reviews looked very professional. However, they omitted important information, or they, well, I don't want to say they lied about the phone, but well, kinda. So that made me review it after all. And if you are not familiar with my channel is more about remote control toys, so not phones. However, again, I felt like reviewing it, giving you some information. Now, I got this phone as an early Christmas present for myself. And, well, maybe you were considering it as well, or something else. So, here is my review of this here phone. Now, let's open the box. Let's see what you get with this phone. Okay, here we go. There is obviously a link in the description to this phone if you want to check it out. The current pricing, availability and such, and specifications. Speaking of which, let me put the specifications of this phone for you on screen right now. And I think the biggest takeaway is, first, its price at the current moment, which made me buy it. And that it has a very contemporary chipset. It's actually, I've had this phone for a month by now. It is a very fast phone. The camera works very well as well. Obviously, you can pause the video if you want a longer look at the specifications. There. It's a bit of a slippery phone, by the way. Okay, it comes in this sleeve, and originally this sleeve was a little tighter, but again, I've used this phone for about a month now, and as you can see, it powers up. Is that visible? Yeah, it is visible. It has a fingerprint sensor. We'll go over the look and the buttons and such in a minute, but it's I've grown fond of this phone. Okay, obviously you get the phone, you get a USB-C cord. I haven't used this one, I had a few others. You get a power brick, and regrettably it has a US style of plug. Doesn't really matter to me, I've got tons of power bricks for phones. But probably with this brick I'd be charging faster. That doesn't really matter that much to me, to be honest. Okay, there's a second level to this box somewhere. Let's see. Ah, here. Yeah, there's a secondary box, a box within the box. And there's not a whole lot in this. But it is kind of important. Some paperwork. Yeah. Okay, you get an USB-C to mini jack adapter. Yes, the phone does not have an audio out. You get a SIM card, a SIM unlock tool, and an outer case, a protective case. And with this case, obviously it protects the phone. It's malleable, as you can see. It also protects the camera a bit. I'm not sure if that's visible, but the camera protrudes a little out of the case, so it doesn't lie flush. That actually makes it easier to pick up. But again, I could imagine some people could be worried about this camera, and with this protective case on it. To be honest, I haven't used a protective case. I'm usually very meticulous about my phones. I never scratch them, I never damage them, so I don't need this sleeve. But actually, it does look pretty good with this sleeve. Huh, now that I look at it again. And this way the camera's lens does not protrude out from the protective case anymore. So this is now flush. It is also a lot less slippery, by the way. The back of the phone is this case is very hard to take off again, by the way, which is a good thing, of course. But the back of the phone itself is ceramic, and it's highly reflective, and it picks up fingerprints easily. There is a huge benefit, though. If you take selfies like so, this acts as a mirror. Not this protective case. This is has a matte finish to it. The phone's case is highly reflective, and again, it acts like an excellent mirror for selfies. Okay, let's have a closer look at the phone itself. Big screen and a very narrow bezel, especially at the top and the sides. At the bottom, there's a little bit more of a bezel, and there's actually a front-facing camera over here as well. You won't be able to see that. I can hardly see it myself, but yes, there is actually a camera there, which I never really use. The camera at the back is of far superior quality anyway. And yes, almost a 6-inch screen. And I've actually done away with my 10-inch pad now that I have this phone. I use this phone to watch YouTube, for instance, when I'm in bed and such. So it's a very crisp and responsive screen. As you can see, the user interface is very responsive as well. This transition, this 3D transition, is something I've chosen. The phone doesn't come with this transition as standard. But it is obviously Android 7.1.1. When I got the phone, it had Android 6 on it, but within a week it offered me an update to 7.1.1, which is great. And let's see, yeah, at the right side of the phone we've got volume rockers over here and an on-off button there. And at the rear we've got ourselves that 12 megapixel camera, a flash which can obviously be used as a torch, and a fingerprint sensor, which is super duper responsive. Yes, I've tried a lot of phones, all Samsung phones. I haven't tried iPhones. I don't really like iPhones. Personal thing, of course. But this fingerprint sensor is... I haven't come across a more responsive or faster fingerprint sensor. So it's well implemented. Very nice. And it's at the right position as well. You always instantly find it. At least I do. Okay, at the top, there's no speaker over here. However, the speaker is over here, and you won't be able to see it. There's a little bit of a slit over here, and the speaker fires through that groove, so to speak. At the bottom, it does have two speakers. I'm not sure. Maybe one of them is a microphone. It does offer stereo sound, though, and of very good quality. I'll show you a YouTube clip in a minute, and let me see what more can I tell you. Xiaomi has its own skin, but you might not even be able to notice it. It's pretty much straight up Android. So that's very, very nice. The skin is very lightweight, so it doesn't cost a whole lot of performance either, which is very, very nice. It does not have hardware buttons in the bezel. Over here you see the buttons in the screen. That probably makes the bezel a bit thinner as well, so that's all right. With that ceramic back, the phone is a little heavier than your typical Android phone. Yeah, even it's even heavier than larger, let's say, Samsung Galaxies. I don't mind. You don't forget about it in your pocket this way, but sure enough, it is a little heavier. Okay, now for one of the things that is omitted in some of the other reviews. And actually, when I looked at the GearBest site, I saw a few people ask about this, and the GearBest people said that it does come with the Google Play Store. And as you can see, I have the Google Play Store over here. Great, but I had to install it myself. So as you probably know, Chinese companies aren't allowed, well, at least they don't like Google software. So let's see, do I actually still have that store that it came with? Over here maybe this. Yeah, oh, this is probably the store that it came with. A Chinese store. What the hell? No, this looks like something else. Yeah, it's in Chinese. What the hell do I know? Right? So, well, suffice to say... Hello? No, I don't want to. Oh, that's actually the normal Play Store installer I just showed you. Oh, App Store, over here. The Mi App Store. Yeah, all kinds of Chinese apps. That might be nice if you are Chinese. But for anyone else, this doesn't really offer much. So, actually, I'll have a link in the description down below to an excellent article showing you or telling you how to actually install the regular Google Play Store. It's very simple. So it's not a big issue, but again, it's something that you should be aware of. If you aren't handy-pandy with phones at all, yeah, maybe you want to stay away from it, but again, it's... just have a look at that article telling you how to install the Play Store. It's very simple. And yeah, with that, I basically have a stock Android phone. I've got Google Drive over here. I've got Maps. I've got the normal Contacts app over here. Everything is in English. So there's no real issue. I can run Instagram and WhatsApp and yeah. Okay, one other thing that's important to me is if this phone is useful for vlogging. So is the camera any good, and is the phone's microphone adequate for that? So let's jump to a test video I shot to assess this phone's capabilities in terms of video. 4K video, by the way. It really has an excellent camera, and how it picks up sound. I haven't edited this part of the video in any way. Yeah, I scaled it down, of course, because this is a 1080p video you are now watching. But I haven't changed the sound level. I haven't altered the video quality, the colors or anything. So let's have a look and listen. Here we go.
Hi there, guys. Welcome to the video. And today I'm testing a camera, and not an action camera this time, but a camera in a phone, the Xiaomi Mix 2. Now this is the second video I'm doing with this camera. The last video, the weather was dreadful. Oh, by the way, a swan. Cool. I don't know if he or she was visible. Anytime. In the last video, the weather was dreadful. So I wanted to do another video in which the weather is a lot better. It's sunny, so we can appreciate the actual colors. And what I'm also testing is the microphone. So if I am audible in this video, I'm shooting directly into the sun at this moment, just to see how that works out with this camera. And yeah, in this video the colors should be a lot more vibrant as well. This is a 4K video. I'm using the camera in its stock settings, so I haven't adjusted sharpness, contrast or exposure or anything.
Okay, I think we can all agree that looked pretty good and detailed. You were able to hear what I said. Compared to, for instance, Samsung phones, the colors are a little less oversaturated. I didn't mind that in my Samsung phones. I've had several Galaxies and Notes. Those phones shoot video in more vibrant colors, I guess. A little oversaturated, but well, I didn't mind that. I didn't mind the way this Xiaomi phone shoots either. It's a little more realistic. And again, I was very well audible, I think. Okay, let's have a look at how it displays YouTube. Okay, let me actually turn the audio down, because would we be testing, right? The microphone in my camera, not really useful. As you can probably tell, the aspect ratio is different, right? Just like on a lot of modern smartphones. And in this Xiaomi phone, they solved that by black bars. Now, in some other phones, the image will be stretched. Yeah, I have no preference either way. This doesn't bother me at all. The image being stretched in other phones didn't really bother me either. This works. And yeah, the screen is very vivid. The audio is very good as well, but again, I could let you listen to the audio, but you'd only be
version one had a lesser
testing camera, the microphone in my camera.
I have no experience with the version one, so I'm not sure what else has been upgraded. Doesn't really matter to me.
Okay, suffice to say, for me, using this as a YouTube watching device works out very well. One other thing I should show you is how responsive the camera for photos in this phone is. Let's try that. All right, two reasons for me doing this indoors. First of all, it's very cold outside, and there's not a lot of colors outside either, as you can probably tell. Second reason is this makes it harder on the camera, right? Less light, always harder for a camera. So let's shoot a few pictures indoors. I'm not sure if you were able to pick up on that, but it's there's no lag at all. Well, hardly noticeable. Click. Yeah, again, I hope you were able to pick up on that. You can switch on HDR. Obviously, you can switch on the flash. I shouldn't be needing a flash in this light. Let's try a slightly darker section over here as well. Yeah, focuses really quickly, and there is hardly any lag in the shutter, which is good, of course. This way you won't be missing that photo opportunity. Alrighty, what more can I tell you about this Xiaomi phone? One more thing. The reason I wanted a new phone was my reception with my older phone wasn't all that great. The Wi-Fi reception was moins, and I hardly ever had 4G, a 4G connection. Now, that was also true for my Samsung phones before that. I guess my house has a lot of rebar in it or something. It's hard to get a good connection. However, with this phone, I haven't had any other connection than 4G. You won't be able to see that, but over here, 4G. Excellent. So that's very nice. I'm happy about that. I didn't know if that would be the case, of course, when I ordered the phone, but obviously I'm happy it has a good connection. Hi there, Onyx. Let's wrap things up. Do I recommend this phone? I am very happy with it, so I guess I should recommend the phone. It has a few downsides, as any product does. It doesn't have an audio jack. For some people that might be a huge thing. I don't really mind. It has a Bluetooth 5, so a wireless headset works out well. And let me see. Yeah, that the phone not coming with the Google Play Store would have been better, obviously, if it had come with the Google Play Store installed, but it's not a huge problem. The phone's internal memory can't be expanded. 256 gigabytes of internal memory. More than enough for me, so I don't really mind. The phone is, by the way, also available in 128 and 64 gigabytes of internal storage. I opted for the biggest one. And that's about it. Those are my thoughts and demonstrations with this Xiaomi phone. Again, there's a link in the description. The specifications are also in the description of this video. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. I'll be happy to answer you. And catch you on the next video. Bye bye.